Hello YouTube, back with another review. This is a Buck Creek copperhead with carbon steel blades. I like this one. I've had this one for a while. I actually taped this onto a extendable pole while doing texture when I was working drywall and went after a badger with it. Yeah, it's probably a good thing that he was in his hole, because if he had come after me, I probably would have been injured. But anyway, it was fun. This knife, oh, I can't even remember. I think I bought this in like 2006. It was brand new at the pawn shop where I got it. It had never been used, carried, or sharpened. It was something that a collector had sold there at the place. I love it when they do that. It's got kind of a strange handle material. It kind of looks like some type of fiber optic type stuff. You can't quite tell, you know, on the video, but I'm sure you can kind of see a little bit of the design. The fit and finish isn't the best. As you can see, there's gaps on either ends of the handle scales. And every so often, I got to kind of clean that stuff out of there, but it doesn't really affect the performance of the knife. The shield is pinned on. I like that. I didn't even know it was pinned on. I've had it all these years and didn't even know. These pins here are all nice and flush ground down. And I appreciate that. It's got the milled bolsters on both sides, of course. I'm going to take a cut and open up the blades for you. Here are the blades opened up. And it's got a, you see it's got a long, I think this is known by some as a French nail nick, or a long pole. And it's just got the regular nail nick there for that blade. This copperhead pattern reminds me quite a bit of the 5 1/4 inch large folding hunter pattern that Chicago Cutlery had done. Also, Schrade Cutlery did the 25 OT, which is a two blader. They've got a similar handle pattern and the same blade pattern, only like I said, it's 5 1/4. I think this is 3 7/8 inches, and you know that I like to do a forced patina on my knives, but this patina, it earned this patina. And that's just from using it a lot, using it, you know, in construction and stuff. And this thing's held up pretty good for everything I've done with it. It's got fish. It's got a deer. Some people think that's too small for gutting deer, but really, you only need about, you know, an inch or two of a blade to get that, you know, cavity open and get those guts out of there. I actually prefer to have a little bit longer blade, honestly. That way it can do most of the reaching instead of my hand. Because I may be a guy, but I don't really particularly like grabbing guts or anything, so. But, yep, yeah, that's just a little quick review. It's made in Solingen, Germany. And I'm not even sure what year this is. I looked for this model on their website. Couldn't find it. Not this particular one. They seem to do all their knives in stainless steel nowadays. But, I don't know. There you go. Here's just a little quick review. Hope you enjoyed it.